Emmanuel Tumusiime Mutebile has been hailed by many as the godfather of the modern-day Ugandan economy. Away from that, the news spoke to a section of business journalists who covered the financial sector and Bank of Uganda specifically on what they thought of his personality.
He was a very humble person because I once attended a fellowship, a Rotary Fellowship, where he was a member at Kampala, Rotary Club, Kampala the Core, where he used to usher. He used to, you know, he would come from a meeting where he is the chief person to speak to, and then you go to a fellowship on Wednesday at Grand Imperial, where he is actually in the welcoming committee.
Samuel Sanya, who covered the central bank for nearly 10 years, said you needed to have done enough research if the former governor was to entertain any question.
One person to always answer every question asked. You basically had to do your research and homework and then ask an informed question. If you were speaking to him in an interview or during the press conferences, you had to know what you were talking about. So we had to do some research.
Saying that he did not have much confidence in the local media, which might have been justified, but I don't think that all journalists in this industry were incompetent. We really have some very, very fine and very grounded journalists in economy.
Mutebile is credited for playing key roles like in the privatization and liberalization of the economy, keeping the runaway inflation that was then a triple digit in check.
The things they did which proved unpopular, was they restructured the civil service. They basically, you know, counted the people, because they used to be ghost people. They cut out the ghosts. They made sure everyone was doing his supposed work. Those who were not doing the work were off. Thousands of people, hundreds of people lost their jobs in that time. Very unpopular, but it was a way to cut down on government expenditure. They also, at that time, they tried very hard to create a cash budget. So basically only spend what is collected in revenue.
However, arguments have been repeatedly made that the government erred when it over-liberalized the economy, including financial institutions like Uganda Commercial Bank. Holders of this view nationalistically reason that this has left key sectors like finance in the hands of foreigners, something they say is detrimental to Ugandans. However, business journalists are of a different school of thought.
Look, you can criticize that it's in foreign hands, but what was the alternative? The alternative was you keep them as a government, you keep pouring money into that thing, inflation keeps going up, would never be where we are today. So you get rid of this stuff.
The case we have is that we have a much more stable banking sector. We have more available credit. I remember back in the 80s or even early 90s, to get a loan from UCB, your project proposal was not enough. You need to get some muscle somewhere. A prominent politician, a big government official. So that's the situation we're in.
Story by Benon Ojambo for the news.